Amuse Korea created a phenomenal six-member boy group by the name of Crossgene. Crossgene debuted in 2012 and have been promoting for a while before they suddenly disappeared. So what happened to them? Well, let's talk about it. In 2012, Casper, Takuya, JG, Sungmin, Shin, and Youngsook debuted with the EP Timeless Begins and title track Lottie Dottie. The following year, the agency released a statement regarding JG's departure from the group, and it reads, "Starting with this album, JG will not be participating in any activities. We want to thank all of you fans who have loved JG of Crossgene. He will start working towards a new path as a singer. Please continue giving JG your interest and love." That's when Saeyoung joined the lineup afterwards. In 2014, Crossgene came back with the single Amazing Bad Lady. Then the guys released I'm Not a Boy, Not Yet a Man. The following year, Crossgene came back with the EP Game and title track Hey You, Nuna. In 2017, we get the EP Mirror and title track Black or White. Come summertime, it was announced that Casper had left the group. The statement reads, "We are making a stunning announcement to the fans who support Crossgene. As of August 31st, Crossgene member Casper has graduated from his activities with Crossgene. Although there has been much discussion up until now with Casper, this conclusion has come to following his strong will due to differences in desired direction and thoughts. We are very sorry to the fans who are always supportive, but Crossgene will from now on be a five-member group. We ask that you continue to support Crossgene in the future as the group will try to make a comeback as soon as possible. Also, we will be grateful if you watch over Casper warmly as he embarks on a different path." Casper also posted on his Weibo with a picture of two palms with the words "I'm sorry" written on them, and then he wrote "I'm sorry" in Chinese, English, Korean, and Japanese. In 2018, we get the EP Zero and title track Touch It. Later that year, Amuse Entertainment announced Takuya's departure from the group in a statement that reads, "To all the fans who support Crossgene, as of December 10th, Crossgene member Takuya has graduated from the group. We are extremely apologetic to be bringing such sudden news to fans who have always shown their support for Crossgene. Takuya has been with us from his trainee days and for approximately 7 years as a member of Crossgene, but he will now be walking a different path from Crossgene with the expiration of his contract. The four remaining members of Crossgene, Shin, Youngsook, Sungmin, Saeyoung, will continue to be more active, not just as individuals, but also as Crossgene. In 2019, we ask for your I'm sorry. We ask for your continued love and support for the members of Crossgene, who continue to work hard to show new sides of themselves. We also ask people to warmly watch over Takuya as he starts his new beginning." So then the remaining members of the group responded to the news as well, and they said, "To our fans who are always supporting us, thank you so much. We are so sorry to bring such sudden and unfortunate news to you. To be honest, we have been working hard till now with a sense of uncertainty about how long we will be able to stay together. However, we have been able to come this far because of your warm support and encouragement. As long as there are fans who support us, we do not want Crossgene to end. Though it is sad that we will be walking a different path from Takuya, who was a member of CrossDream with us for approximately 7 years, we want to show our support for Takuya in his decision to walk down a new path. From this point onwards, we will continue our CrossDream activities with four members. We will continue to work harder and create a new future with you all. We will do our best to create a space for us to meet you all face to face in 2019. We would be grateful if you could wait just a little bit longer, and we hope you continue to watch over CrossGene. So, Takuya opened up about several elements in his life pertaining to his time living in South Korea. Regarding his experience as an idol, Takuya stated, "In the early days of our debut, our group underwent a change in members, and I had a hard time back then." He confessed, "At that time, I was the leader and not Shin Won-ho, and so there were many times that didn't go the way that I hoped. I think that's why I felt that way." I wouldn't be surprised that Takuya decided to step down because, you know, as we could see from, like, the Nine Muses documentary of how, you know, the members are treated, and especially the weight the leader carries. Being in the leadership position does not sound glamorous, because no matter what happens with the other members, if anyone falls short on an expectation or responsibility or a goal or a deadline, they don't look at that one person. They look at the leader, and they blame the leader, and they question the leader's capabilities. So with Takuya being, you know, somebody from Japan and being the first Japanese idol to debut in K-pop, I'm not speaking for him, but if I had to guess why he decides to step down from the leadership role, I would say it probably had to do with the immense pressures he was under, which was probably super unfamiliar to him. And then, you know, also having ideas and, like he said, things just not going your way, or having expectations and things, like he said, just not going his way. So yeah, that's just my little thoughts. Let me know what you guys think. But moving forward, the following year, Sangmin and Young-seok decided not to renew their contracts with the agency, followed by Se-young, who announced his departure from the group sometime in 2020. At this point, CrossGene has not officially disbanded. However, they have not actively promoted as a unit in a very long time. A large part of that is due to the fact that the guys had to serve their military time, so they took, you know, the time to do that. But I believe they are all done with that, if I'm not mistaken. Sungmin and Young-seok confirmed that they are still a part of CrossGene, and CrossGene is still together, even though they're not a part of the agency. They're just saying that the group itself is on hiatus until all of the military services are complete. So I'm not sure who still is doing their military service, but maybe they're just waiting until after that. Also, the guys kind of went into service around the time of, like, COVID, so that pretty much changed a lot of things within the K-pop industry and how things are done, and probably their likeliness of making a comeback sooner, you know. So a lot of things kind of play into part as to why that they haven't come back yet. So anyways, what are the guys up to now? Shin, I believe, is the only member left under Amuse, and he doesn't seem to be active on his social media. Sungmin doesn't appear to be active on any social media platforms either. Young-seok is a musical actor and has been laying low online as well. Se-young is now a YouTuber. His channel name is Koi-blen. Takuya is now under the agency Different Company as a model and actor. Casper and JG have joined some variety TV shows since moving on from CrossGene, and they appear to be continuing their aspirations in the entertainment industry. And that is all that I have for the group, you guys. I'll be honest with you, I had no idea who these guys were. They never came across my radar, so it was very interesting for me to research them. I know that they had so many Japanese projects. I didn't go over all of them. It was just too many to, like, go over. But, and really, I focus on K-pop, as you guys can tell. I don't really focus on the Japanese stuff, because that's, like, a whole different department. That's, you know, they're promoting in a totally different language, a totally different country and stuff like that. And, you know, so this channel mainly focuses on, like, K-pop. once a Korean group starts promoting in Japan, I consider that J-pop, even if they're, a K-pop group. If they're doing Japanese singles, they're doing J-pop or whatever. So, yeah, but that's just me. That's my opinion. I do think that it's interesting how Crush Jean has had so many Japanese projects, but barely, if any, Chinese promotions, even though they had at one point two Chinese members in the group. So I wonder what that was about. But I did like their concept, and I would like to see them come back, hopefully. That would be pretty cool. So let me know your thoughts on Crush Jean, and until the next video, I'll see you around. Masalam.